Thanks to Dehancer for sponsoring this video.
How you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Yeah.
We finally got it together. Sloan is an OG, so
you're an OG. You know, what do you mean?
I mean, but you're an OG because we shot together like back in the day.
We did.
It's been a minute. We actually set this up behind us. It was totally different over here.
Yeah, it's all about finding like the placement, especially with you, because you have such a creative eye for finding like something about even the smallest amount of space and turning them into a whole scene. So. It's really cool that like something, even like a corner of a room like this, is gonna look like a huge, huge scene that you fully curated because it's Mike.
I gotta shoot you more because you make me feel really good about myself. We're gonna be shooting on the OG because I shot you on the OG last time, which is a Pentax.
One of my favorite cameras.
Come on. So we're shooting on a Pentax 6.7. And it's been a while. I found some Portra 800 for $75 on Amazon. I'm not sure what the price point is at the moment. But I felt like we got a decent deal. We're shooting inside and we're gonna shoot some digital, but that'll be for Dehancer. Thank you to Dehancer for sponsoring this video. Shouts out to Victor behind the camera, always coming in to save the day.
He's a sweetheart, we love Victor.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's do it. I didn't bring my light meter today, so I'll use my Pentax, but I'm comfortable with everything. So it's no experiments. We're gonna get some shots. So without further ado, let's do it. We're gonna shoot at 800, at 60. Let's see how this looks. Let's see here. Okay, so this is where things get a little technical. All right. There we go. I think that'll get the job done. What we do with room corners.
3, 2, 1.
Because it's dimly lit, I just take a little time to make sure my focus is good. You feel me? Okay, just making sure. So now we're getting a little closer to her. So we're gonna cheat some of the props. You know, it's all about getting what best suits the shot. Victor, I can see your reflection in the picture. Right there. Is that cool? See, attention to detail. You know, back when I first started, I wouldn't have cared about that. I would have been like, I could just remove that in post. But nah, you can't remove that.
3, 2, 1.
Damn. You know, each camera angle, you gotta do a different set design. So bear with me, Sloan. One more. Oh, no more. I think that's all we need.
Okay.
And I'm out of film, so on to the next location. Well, hello there. We're back with the second look. I think I'm gonna let Sloan give the rundown of this vibe because I've never shot anything like this, but it looks sick.
We're kind of going for a very high fashion editorial look. And we're gonna kind of make it more Mike's speed, so.
Which is a vibe that the editorial world is something that I've been trying to like capture more of and do more of. So I think that this was just a wonderful collaboration and Sloan just fails to disappoint. I think we just hop right into this shit.
Of course. Probably put it into black and white as well.
Yes. Keep in mind that this will be in black and white unless we get a color shot that's just undeniably good to where it's just impossible, but it'll probably be black and white for sure. Can we move the feet a little closer to one another? Yeah.
Where do you want
That right there, yeah, that's cool. Damn, that's tough. All right, you can come on down.
Cool.
Damn. That's some different shit.
You liking the fit? So strange.
Am I liking the fit? Yeah. Let's see how this rocks. Yep. Now we've moved to the location within the location. You know, we got these from the Los Angeles National Forest. We got these imported.
My
backyard. Yeah. And and yeah, we got some just dysfunction going on around here. They like, she been building, the story behind, what's the story to you behind? Yeah, like what's going on? Like when I capture these photos right now of you with all of this shit, what would you say this woman has going on?
I mean, this would definitely be a proper representation of the past 2 weeks of my life, considering this was a 200-year-old tree that fell in the backyard. So now we're gonna make some tables out of it.
Wow, well that'll be very cool, and you know, I'll get some pretty cool pictures, so I'm sorry that...
You'll get a cool side table.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah. Apologize about the 200-year-old tree falling, but hey, okay. it's creating, it's allowing us to create art. Yeah. And when we're allowed to, you know, there you go. What are you about to do? I want to make sure you say, oh, okay, all right, you got it. All right, Sloan has it. There we go. Oh! We don't have production insurance, Sloan, so you gotta be safe. That was a close one. Yeah, I rock with that. That's cool. All right. I mean, I think we got a lot. How do you feel? Do you feel like we can keep going?
I feel like we can keep going.
Okay, well, we gonna shoot until, come on, let's go. Get all the vibes, let's go. Like some playa, like some chill, yeah, like, yeah. Yes. Sloan's too cool. Damn. All right. This could actually be sick color. Because the greens in the back, it looks sick with the brown. Yeah, I think this may have to be color for sure. Damn, this may be like my winner, my favorite. Just because it looks good to me in color. So I don't know. Maybe it could be one of those, like I get the film and it's not as cool as it looks, but all right. So we're gonna get some comparisons. I'm shooting her super wide on the iPhone 13 Pro Max. Now let's see what we got here. But these will be black and white. And they will be raw. I'm shooting them in raw. All right. Honestly, these may not be that bad shit. Okay, got that. And I'm shooting like film. Boom, okay. And can we get one more shot of the stairs?
Of course.
So, technically, y'all are able to see the difference between the Dehancer film simulation app and a film camera. Yep, let's see, yep. Damn, hold on, hold that. Put your foot up. Honestly, that looks sick. So y'all don't sleep on
crazy styling.
Victor is telling me you can't sleep on crazy styling and iPhone photos. I'm sorry. But now I see why a lot of these models like will post the iPhone photos instead of the pictures, which I don't understand, but do you understand that?
But at the same time, it's the same industry I work in, so I see it a lot.
Yeah, so.
A lot.
Sloan sees it a lot, so.
What's going on, guys? First off, thank you to Dehancer for sponsoring this video. I think we may start off with the Dehancer app, and then we can get into everything else if that's cool with y'all. This app isn't for a professional photographer who's doing a $60,000 campaign for Vogue, right? Or however much. This is for the person who may not have a film camera, who shoots on their iPhone, or even if you shoot digital and you want some film simulated profiles, I think that this is the perfect app for you. I'm thoroughly impressed on the film profiles that they've simulated in this app. I shoot a lot of film. I've seen a lot of different film stocks, and the similarities with these profiles are pretty impressive, but I know that a lot of scientific work has gone into creating these film profiles. So this isn't like your average Lightroom preset. There's been a lot of research and testing going on with the film profiles. So that is why they've been able to get so close to the actual stock. Without further ado, let's hop on this app. So we're gonna go to the Dehancer app, and boom. Honestly, I think I like the first picture. Actually, we're gonna go, and you see I shot it raw. It tells you the type of file that you're shooting on: raw, TIFF, JPEG, whatever. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a color photo and I'm gonna make a black and white photo, just so you guys can see the differentiation between the photos. So as y'all know, I think we're gonna go to category, and they have a list of different presets you can get. So they have the Dehancer team presets that they've created, imported presets, my presets, which is cool. You can create your own presets if you have something in particular or a look in particular you wanted to create. And I think I'm gonna go to all presets because it has all of the film stocks that you guys may be familiar with. So I'm gonna go, as y'all know, to my favorite. Honestly, let's mix it up. They have CineStill. Come on now, 800T, CineStill 50D. Oh man, okay. Fuji, Kodak, they have Kodak Portra 400, Ilford HP5, all of that. I think let's go with the CineStill 50D. Shouts out to CineStill, man. This has been a film stock that I have used quite a bit. We're gonna go to CineStill, boom. And if you guys see, you know, there's a lot of grain and things of that sort. Naturally, with the film stocks on here, I will say you get quite a bit of grain, and you can edit. That's the beautiful thing about this. So y'all can see, honestly, this is beautiful. The CineStill 50D film preset is pretty close if you ask me. So we're gonna go to edit. I'm gonna go to film grain, and we're gonna bring the film grain down just because I think there's enough and I don't want it to be too grainy. What's cool about this is if you go to print, you can go and choose the different papers. 2383 print film, usually I choose the glossy paper. I like the contrast that you get from that glossy paper. And let's get to work. So we're gonna bring up the exposure a little bit. Let's give us some contrast. Boom, boom. Y'all know I love my photos kind of contrasty. I'm not even gonna lie. We got the glossy paper. Now let's go to expand. Right here is where you can fix your black points and your white points. I'm gonna bring the black point down a little bit just to add to that contrast. You got those nice, delicious looking blacks, and you can see the greens. It's just beautiful, beautiful image. Let's bring the white point right about there. And you can also change your color mode, so Luma or normal. I usually just keep it on normal, and boom, we got a CineStill 50D emulated photo. You can push and pull your film like in a real film lab. So we're gonna see if that does anything. Oh, that's fire. Okay, so when you pull it, the colors change, the tones change a little bit. Ooh, you get more of the reds in her hair. Oh, that's a vibe. That's a vibe. I don't even want to touch that. So, let's boom, save to gallery. export, and we're good to go. I know that there's a lot of people who are watching who are getting their start in photography who have iPhones. This is a great start. You can edit on your iPad. They have this app on the iPad. Anything with an iOS platform, you can download the app on. We're hopping on the Dehancer app one more time, and I think that I want to do a black and white image. Boom. Okay. Found the black and white image. Okay, it's already a lot going on. This is the last edit. And you can see, you see the halations with the CineStill 50D. That's fire. We're gonna rock with one of my favorite film stocks, which is the Ilford HP5. It's one of my favorite black and white film stocks aside from Kodak T-Max, but we're gonna rock with the Ilford HP5. So let's see. HP5, 400 glossy paper. Somebody created that. Shout outs to I Am Trees for creating the Ilford HP5+. Okay, so y'all know we're gonna choose the preset. We're gonna go to edit, hound in on it. First off, we're gonna go to the film grain, bring that film grain down as much as I can. We're gonna bring that resolution down a little bit. Y'all can see the film working on the top left side. And black and whites are always so easy to me, because if you shoot on black and white, you're limited to what you can do. As y'all know, it's really no secret. I love super poppy and contrasty black and white photos. And let's go to the contrast. So we go to print. I'm gonna rock with the Kodak glossy paper per usual, and we're gonna push it. Let's push that contrast all the way. I don't know, man. A lot of people don't like very heavily contrasted photos, but I love the contrast. You can give me all the contrast in the world. And at this point, I think I got what I need. It's really nothing more I need to do to this photo. But like I said, you can change the temperature. I mean, y'all download the app so you can see everything you can do. We're gonna save that to the gallery, exporting, boom. And y'all can see both images on the screen right now. Thank you, thank you, thank you to Dehancer. I think that this is a very cool app for beginners and people who are professionals but love taking iPhone photos and want that film look. If you're interested in learning more about Dehancer, visit the links in my description. And without further ado, we can get into the remaining portion of the video. I want to thank Sloan for coming in, crushing it per usual. She killed it with the styling, the poses. Shooting more editorial work is something that I've really been wanting to do, and I've been doing it more recently that y'all will see. But this lens, man, this Pentax 6.7 45 millimeter lens is incredible. It's perfect for editorial photos. And though I use the 90 mil for some of the shots, I think the majority of the photos that we took outside, I used the 45 millimeter because I wanted to get full body. I wanted you to see the outfit. And I think that with editorial shots, you want to see the styling. The styling is very prevalent in the story that you're telling. So you got to go wide for a lot of the shots, especially depending on where you are in the composition of the image. So use your resources. You don't need the film camera to start. I scratched the surface. There's so much you can do on that app, but I just wanted to show you how you can take a picture from start to finish that fast on the app and how cool it is. And I enjoyed it. So like the video if you rocked with it, subscribe to the channel, and as I always say, stay safe, stay healthy, stay shooting. I'll see y'all on the next one. We out.